I'm Lynn.
And we're the art duo Lululin.
Today's video is sponsored by Texas Art Supply. We're looking at how ink is affected by four different types of papers. We have a watercolor paper, a rice paper, a Bristol board, and a vellum paper right here. We're using a quash water brushes and a traditional Chinese gold black ink. I initially wanted to pour this ink into the water brush, but it got really clogged and it wouldn't come out, so I ended up dipping this into a plate of this ink. So we're starting out with wet on dry technique, which is where you're applying the ink directly onto a dry piece of paper. The watercolor paper on the top left-hand corner is the hardest to make thin lines with due to the texture of the paper. It's really rough, but it's the easiest to blend on because the ink doesn't absorb immediately, so you have plenty of time to have the water blend the ink smoothly. To the right of that is the rice paper. That's the most absorbent. It's really hard to control the thin lines because if you get too much ink on your brush, it'll bleed through the paper. The Bristol, which is on the bottom left-hand corner, absorbs the second fastest, and the blending isn't completely smooth because of how quickly it absorbs. The vellum, which is on the bottom right-hand corner, is pretty fun and easy to create thin lines on. It's the least absorbent, which means that you really have to be careful about smudging. Next, we're working with wet on wet painting technique, which means that I've pre-wet all of the papers with water first, and I'm applying the wet ink onto there. So the vellum is going to be the worst to use because it distorts really, really heavily with the water. It becomes super buckled. And so you don't have very good control over where the ink flows to, and in the end the paper is not flat. The Bristol and the watercolor react pretty similarly. I like the watercolor more because the ink spreads in a more veiny fashion, which I thought was really beautiful. The Bristol also absorbs the water a little bit more, and so you have less control. It doesn't spread as quickly around. The rice paper shows off the gold the best, but I don't really recommend trying to blend with it. What you can see is that you really have your darks and you have your lights, but you don't really have that smooth in-between blend. The other thing is that it soaks through, so you really need to be sure to use a table cover because the ink will just stain whatever table you're on. I ended up picking the watercolor paper because I wanted to feature different values in this demonstration. But if you want to do just a really simple line drawing using mostly dark areas, I would recommend using the rice paper, because as I said before, it shows off the gold the best.